We'll start with a story about Theseus. And Theseus was an astronaut. He was the astronaut in charge of the spaceship of Theseus. And the spaceship of Theseus was involved in NASA's most ambitious space project yet. All the crowds of people, they gathered at the launch pad at NASA. And they gathered to watch the countdown as the spaceship of Theseus prepared to blast off into space for a mission that would last a very, very long time. So you might know that missions in space can last months or years. This mission was going to last 7 years. Now, they imagined that some things would go wrong on this mission over 7 long years, but they couldn't have imagined quite how many things would go wrong. So, early on in the mission, just as they left the Earth's atmosphere, there was a terrible meteor strike, and it struck each one of the windows of the spaceship of Theseus. They were cracked and so badly damaged that they needed to be replaced. First one needed to be replaced, and then the others cracked, became so dangerous that they needed to be replaced as well. And finally, there was the case that every single one of the windows on the spaceship of Theseus had to be replaced. Now their mission continued, and they thought maybe that's the last of the problems behind us, but it wasn't, because once they were deep in space, they collided with the space station, and they knocked off one of the wings of the spaceship of Theseus, and one of the crew had to do a daring spacewalk to replace that. And you might be thinking that by now they've been a bit clumsy, but there was another near collision with a part of a comet. And didn't that knock off the other of the wings of the spaceship of Theseus? As they made their way through space, 5 years, 6 years, the outer casing of the spaceship of Theseus became really damaged by cosmic rays. And bit by bit, each of the tiles that make up the outer casing became so damaged it needed to be replaced, until they got to the point where every single piece of the outer shell of the spaceship had been replaced. The astronauts were preparing to make their entry into Earth, and they were reflecting on how almost all of the spaceship of Theseus had been completely replaced. But then one astronaut thought, well, at least there's one thing that's the same. The very core of the spaceship of Theseus, the engine and all of the electrical components, at least they're still all in one piece. At least we can say that we set out with the engine and we're going to return to Earth with the engine too. But they shouldn't have said that. They spoke too soon, because just as they said that, there was a terrible whirring and terrible noise, and they realised to their horror that even the engine had packed in. And they had to make a really complicated mission to mend the engine. And eventually they realised that the whole of the engine needed to be replaced as well. So, here's the crew on the spaceship Theseus. In a spaceship made of completely new parts that have been gradually replaced over 7 years. And finally, and thankfully, they make their daring re-entry into Earth through the Earth's atmosphere and back to the launch pad at NASA, where the crowds are gathered again. And the crowds cheer and they say, Theseus is back, the spaceship of Theseus is back. But my first question for you is, are they right? Are the crowds right when they say, here it is, the spaceship of Theseus is back? Is it the spaceship of Theseus? Can you talk to the person next to you and say yes because or no because? Can you come out together? Right then, here's how it starts off. Is it the Spaceship of Theseus? Yes, because, or no, because?
Yes, because, yes and no, because. It is, because the people inside it and the controls inside it haven't changed. But it is a different ship, because the parts on the outside are different to what it left off as.
Okay, yes and no. So if you had to make a decision, if you had to decide whether it was the Ship of Theseus or not, which one of those answers, yes or no, are you most drawn to?
I don't know, because basically you call them out because the people in the control are the same, but the outside and the winds and the windows aren't the same.
Thank you. Pass on to someone.
Thank you, Simon. I think it is, and I think it's not. I think it is because, say they've come back down to Earth, the people don't know it's the new one. They might just still think it's the old one where it is from, they've got from Earth. And no, because it's not the old one like it normally, they've changed it. They've got the same kind of spaceship, but they've changed it all. They've changed the windows and engine and all that.
Thank you. Two people describing this feeling that you sometimes get, where you strongly think one thing and strongly think another thing at the same time. How strange. Pass on, are there other reasons for thinking?
I think yes and no, but mainly yes, because if you break something and buy another one the exact same, it would still be yours, but just the new one. So it broke his spaceship, but he got a new one. And it still is. And when he returns to Earth, it'll still be his, because it don't belong to anyone else except Theseus.
I say no, it's not the same spaceship, because when you're up in space, it's got the same controls and stuff, but when you're up in space, he changed every single part to it. So I don't think it's a spaceship itself, because it's not the same one what went up, but it's got all different parts.
Collect a few more ideas. Is there anything that's not been said so far? Is there anyone with a handout thinking, my thought, my reason for thinking it is or it isn't, hasn't been said yet? Keith?
It's gone up to space in that one there, and then it's came back down a complete different spaceship. It's had cracked windows, wings off, but and shell off and that, an engine, but inside it's still the same. Well, I don't think inside will be same as well, because they've had all new parts, but inside might have been changed a little bit when they've been taking the shell off.
Let's imagine two things then. Let's imagine first, if the inside is still the same, what would your answer be? So if the astronauts' sandwiches are still in place, or their pen and their notepad are still there, if the inside is still the same, what was your answer be to the question, is it the Ship of Theseus?
No, because that would have all gone when the things had been getting broke. Like if the school was on fire, everything would go. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So Keith sounds like Keith is imagining the other thing. He's imagining if the inside was not the same anymore. Let's imagine that every coffee cup, every pencil, every notepad, every photograph of an astronaut's children, all of those things have changed. So there was nothing left on the inside of this ship at all. Then, what's your answer, thank you?
I think, yeah, because the people are still there, so it won't affect the other things that are inside, if the people are still inside.
Ah, okay. So, I want you to decide whether you agree or disagree with Keith. He said, if all of the outside, all of the inside, and every single pencil and coffee cup and everything's changed, He still thinks it will be the same spaceship because the people inside are the same. Can you show if you agree or disagree or are not sure about Keith's idea? Keith, please choose someone who will connect directly with that idea. Okay, not a new idea, but connecting with your idea.
It's still a spaceship, but it's not the actual spaceship that went to space.
What does that distinction mean? It's a spaceship, but it's not the spaceship of Theseus.
Because it's like got all different parts to it now, and it's not the same.
What would make it the same?
If it had the same parts and engine and that.
So if it had all of these parts that are on the carpet, or just some of them, would you want it to have all of these, every single window, wing, engine, exactly the same, or if it just had a couple of them? Like?
All of them.
All of them. It's only the same spaceship if every single one of those parts is the same.
Yeah.
Okay. Pass on to somebody else then, please. Thank you for showing if you agree or disagree. That's lovely.
Well, if it's not the same spaceship that went to space, well, I think it is, because if like everything inside is the same, but everything on the outside isn't, because if everything on the inside is the same, then it's exactly the same spaceship, because it's got all the same buttons and everything.
Ah, thank you. So if it's got that one part, those parts in the core still the same, it's the same spaceship. But what if, like we were saying with Keith, all of the parts inside, the buttons, the coffee cups, the photographs of children, the pencils and paper, all of the inside bits have also changed so that there's nothing left from the spaceship of Theseus that blasted off? Then what do you reckon? Is it the spaceship of Theseus then, if we imagine that?
No, because the outside isn't the same.
Thank you. Pass on, please.
I think yes, because it's the same design, and it's like kind of the same thing, because it's the same design that looks the same. Maybe everything in the inside is the same as well. So I think yes.
Okay. Where am I now? If the inside was different, if the inside was different, can you tell us the significance or the importance of the design being the same? If it's made out of new parts, but the same design, so the red wings are on the side and the green windows are in the middle, same design, looks the same. Can you tell us why that same design means it's the same spaceship of pieces?
Well, like, the other broken parts are like the same as parts that they've used for the new rocket, and the rocket itself is not the actual like rocket as the broken parts, but it's the rocket, like the design of it.
Okay. So if something is made to the same design, is it the same?
Kind of, yeah.
Kind of. Dessie's got a thumbs down. She disagrees with something. Dessie, can you explain what exactly, precisely, you're disagreeing with, please?
I'm disagreeing with the cards. Like you said earlier.
Just rewind a second. Nope. What exactly are you disagreeing with? Whose idea?
Well, a bit of everyone's, because.
You're disagreeing with a bit of everyone's idea.
Because, some people are on about where if the. Cups and pencil cases and that are in it. It doesn't mean that, because you're asking if the spaceship, not the actual things inside of the spaceship.
So, that's funny. Does it matter whether the pencils and coffee cups are the same or different to our question? Is it the spaceship of Theseus?
No, because the question was, is it a spaceship of Theseus? But it can be the spaceship and it can be not, because at the start it was the spaceship, because it went It was probably his design, and it might not have been his design. And at the end, it still kind of is, because it's the same design as the first one, but it's just new stone.
Okay, thank you. Let's see if I'm one of the person, and then I've got something else to ask you.
Thank you. I think I agree, and I'm in between. I agree, because it doesn't really matter if the inside is the same, because it's just, it's the outside, it's like the spaceship design that is the same or not the same, or it, I don't know really.
We've talked about two things inside the spaceship. We've talked about pens and pencils and coffee cups and stuff, but then going back to someone else's idea, who said this? The people inside the spaceship are the same. Put your hand up if that was your idea. Who said the people inside are still the same? Yeah. You're not confessing to coming up with the idea. I thought someone said that idea. So there are two things that we could say are inside. Keith said that the people are inside, so it's still the spaceship of Theseus. But do you think it's relevant that the people are inside? Do we not care whether it's pens or pencils or people? When we ask, is it the spaceship of Theseus, should we forget about that stuff?
I don't think we should include pencils or coffee cups. Is it still the spaceship of Theseus? And I think it is. I think it is because, well, the one that set off is, and the one that come back down
is. Okay.
Because it's changed a lot.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going to ask everybody now, if they think it is the spaceship of Theseus when it lands back at Earth, I want you to stay seated. If you think it's no longer the spaceship of Theseus, I want you to stand. And if you just can't decide, I want you to stay seated but put your hand on your head. Okay, off you go. So, the people who are standing up, they think, just double checking, that it's no longer the spaceship of Theseus that lands. Have I got that right? With their hands on their head, I'm sure. People who are just sitting, they think, no, it is still the spaceship of Theseus. Okay. I'm just wanting to draw your attention to some of the fantastic reasons that you've given so far. We're going to hear from a couple of people, and I want them just to choose the best reason that they have heard for why they're standing up, sitting down, their hands on their head. Okay, we're just going to ask one person from each of those three groups. Here are your reasons. You said, it's the same crew, the same people. You said, but there's different parts. You said, the people down at the launch pad, they don't know about the changes. You said, well, if you break something in another situation, if you just break something and mend it, that doesn't normally make it a new thing. You said, the spaceship still belongs to Theseus. You said, it's not the same ship that's set off. And finally you said, but it is the same design. So there's lots of arguments, lots of reasons to think one thing or the other. Let's hear from someone standing up, sitting down and hands on head, the best argument they've heard, either one on the board or one that hasn't been said yet.
I'm still saying that it's not the same spaceship because it's gone out of space and then it's been all redesigned with, well, not redesigned in the same colour, but it's been redesigned as in different parts.
Hmm. Do you have a feeling, if it's not the same ship, when exactly it stopped being the spaceship of Theseus?
Soon as the windows were changed.
Wait, the very first window?
Yeah.
The first window. As soon as it got a new window, it's a brand new ship. Okay, thank you. Let's hear from someone who's sitting down.
Okay. Well, if you break a window at a house, the house still belongs to you, but it's the same with Theseus because if it belongs to them, someone, when they land, someone's not going to just say it's mine because you've changed your design, because Theseus has claimed it to be his, and that's, so it's his station.
Thank you, Sophie. And that was a helpful example. Okay. Olivia, you're in the middle. Can you explain why?
I'm in the middle because it might not be a new one. It could be still the same, but just new things inside it or on it.
Thank you. Okay, everyone sit down. So, there's a bit more to this story than meets the eye. There's a part two to the story, do you want to hear it?
Yeah.
So, when the spaceship did land, the people on the launch pad had a very similar conversation to the conversation that we're having. They were unsure about whether this ship, the one that landed, is the spaceship of Theseus or not. And when they heard that every single one of the parts had been replaced, loads of people scratching their head. And then the crew of the spaceship of Theseus told them a secret. All of these parts that had been broken, they weren't just set loose to float around in space. They were actually stored up in containers inside the spaceship of Theseus. They were stored, all broken in pieces, but stored up. And when they got back to Earth, the excellent engineers at NASA, they were able to put all the pieces back together again. They put all the broken windows back into place. They put the battered wings back together, and each of the little tiles that made up the outer shell, they were put back together as well. You couldn't blast off in this rocket, but it's back together in the same design, in the same order, made of all of those pieces that were there that day 7 years ago when the spaceship of Theseus blasted off. And so they said to the people, look, there's two, and now it's fine, it's up to you to decide which is the spaceship of Theseus. Whichever one's the spaceship of Theseus, we'll put in the museum with the label, the spaceship of Theseus. But this didn't solve the problem. In fact, it created much more of a problem than there ever was before, because now we've got the question, which is the spaceship of Theseus? Okay? The spaceship that came back, or the spaceship that set out? Okay? Came back or set out? Have a chat with the person next to you, see what you think. Now where are we at? Which one's the spaceship of Theseus? So what the engineers have done in order to help, they've actually made things even more puzzling. Which is the spaceship of Theseus? What do you think?
I think the one that's being set out is because that's the one that's maybe the right materials. The one that came about, that was maybe with different materials.
Can you tell us what you mean by the right materials?
Because the one that was set out were a bit maybe like metal, and the one that's being given back, you don't know if it's maybe the right metal, what was set out.
Thank you. Pass to somebody else, please. Which is the spaceship of Theseus? The one that set out or the one that came back? The blue one or the red one?
I think the red one's the spaceship because that one set out to space but it just broke in space. And that this one's the original but that one isn't, that's just like a copy.
So I went. Tell us that again, but this time call them the one that set out and the one that came back, so everybody follows. So say that again.
That the red one, this one, near me, that one set out and the other one
came back. Lovely. The red one set out, the blue one came back. So which one is the spaceship of these?
The red one.
The red one. And just explain your reason again for everyone.
Because that one went into space, but it just broke in space, and that one made by the ship, the spaceship.
Ah, so who it was made by is important.
Yeah.
Thank you. No one said that yet. Pass on to someone who thinks something different. Oh, someone right next to you thinks something different.
I think it's both of them are the same because the one got set off, when it's broken, it's still the same, but the new one, it's still the same because they look the same. Yeah, and when they just go for the same because when the first one got broken, all of it, and then they replaced all of it again, it's still the same thing.
Okay. So, but which of them is the spaceship of Theseus, do you think? They look the same. So which is the Spaceship of Theseus?
Both of them.
Both of them. Okay, Henry, you disagree?
I only think the one with the red pen lid underneath is the right one because it went out to space, but it came back, but it even though it's put it back together, it won't be able to fly ever again.
Why is that important to remember?
Because if you put the other one in what will be able to fly, you'd have to build another rocket to go if you're going to do another mission.
Ah.
So there's no point building another rocket when you've already got one what works and you've got one what don't work, and the Theseus has been in them both.
Okay, thank you. People are really spotting similarities and differences between them and identifying which differences are important to the question, which is the Ship of Theseus. So many people want to say something. Let's have a couple of quick responses from people. Why don't we do this? Why don't we go along and hear from all of these people who've got their thumbs out in a quick sentence, please?
Because the one with the red one, the red one is the one what they set out in. The blue one is the wrong one because it's not been made by like the parts what they set off in.
I think it's none of them because if the blue one, if that one's made with new parts, then it's not the right one. And the red one, if that one's been broken up into small pieces and it's been brought back down in the blue one, then it's not going to be the same one.
I think yes, because both of them have the same design and the same exterior and both the same interior, and I think the one that's set off in should go in museum, and that should keep the blue one.
So they both can be the Spaceship of Theseus.
So both are.
They both are. That's weird, isn't it? Because they started off being just one Spaceship of Theseus. The Spaceship of Theseus, that's what we called it. The one that they were in, they blasted off. Somewhere in this journey, one became two. When? When did one spaceship turn into two? What's wrong?
Well, kind of like Cameron said, they're both like the same spaceship. They're both the spaceship, the same design because, well, they're both the same design and also, well, one of the one like Cameron said, one the red one they should keep in the museum, and the people who made it, the blue one, they should keep that. But like, if you want to set off again.
Okay. Put your hand out. You still were hoping to say something. Okay, lovely. Pass on, please.
I think the red one. Because if they couldn't fit all the parts out they are now in the other spaceship, they might have built into a lot of tiles and then stored them in there while the children got back, and then when they got kind of built it back up.
Yeah. So if they did do that, if they did make all those little tiles back into a spaceship, which one would be the Spaceship of Theseus? Would it be the one that returned to Earth, or would it be the one that was remade out of all the tiny tiles?
The one that set it off there.
Okay. Why the one that set off? Why is that the Spaceship of Theseus?
Because all of the stuff, like the pens, papers, and all of the work stuff in there that they needed to get
is in
there,
so
it's the
Spaceship of Theseus.
Okay, lovely. Pass on, please.
I think the red one should go into the museum because they're both kind of Theseus. Because Theseus might have helped make that second one in space, and Theseus might have helped with the first one. But the first one doesn't work anymore, and Theseus Theseus went up in it to start to go to space, but didn't come down in it. But it doesn't work, though. The blue one should be for another mission.
Okay, so we've been thinking about lots of different things, lots of different reasons for thinking which could be the Spaceship of Theseus. We've been asking which one works as a spaceship, which one has Theseus helped with, which one is made of the original parts, which one is made to the same design. Three people now have mentioned this answer, which is both of them are the Spaceship of Theseus. And so I want us to spend the final part of our session exploring whether this idea is possible and whether it makes sense. Can one thing become two? Can there be one Spaceship of Theseus with that name, and then through some kind of process, there is two things called the Spaceship of Theseus? Do you think this is a good answer to the question? Does it solve our problem, or does it not solve our problem? What do you reckon? It's a really interesting response. Let's evaluate this idea of three people apart that are both of the Spaceship of Theseus, okay? So to do it, you need to speak in a slightly bigger group than twos. I want the twos to join together in fours or fives, okay? Tell us where you are at. Charlie, you're letting everyone know what you think about Mia's idea, and I think Sean shared it, and a few other people, where they said, oh, and also Cameron, they said they're both of them in the Ship of Theseus. And I was wondering, that means somehow, along the way, the Ship of Theseus has become two. One has become two. I was wondering what people think about this idea. Does it solve the problem, or is it a new problem in its own right? Charlie, what do you reckon?
Well, the red one, they weren't up in it, but they came back down in the opposite one. They're both the same design, and they've both been copied, so like when one of them breaks, it's still the Theseus one.
Thank you. So, do you think this is a helpful answer to both of them with the Ship of Theseus?
Yeah, because one of them does, one of them won't go off and one of them won't work.
Okay. So they're different then. You're describing them as being different. So, is one of them the Spaceship of Theseus, or is Mia right and both of them are the Spaceship of Theseus? Okay. Even though they're different in the way you described. Please can you pass to... I can see a handful of people, like Trafford, and who've not had a chance, or Osha, who've not had a chance to say much. So choose somebody like that.
I think it's a problem in its own right because it set off as one, and that was the Spaceship of Theseus. But when it came back down, it turned into two.
When it came back down, it happened.
Yeah, there was two in space, because it went into space as one, but then came back down as a different one.
So sometime in space there was two ships?
No, there's never been two ships.
Okay. So if we go to Mia's answer, which was both the ship of Theseus, are you not happy with that answer?
Yeah, they are both the Ship of Theseus, because he drove them both, mm-hmm. and it was his crew who fixed them.
Okay. Can you just say a little bit more then, though, about what you were, just to help us understand what you meant when you said in space that there were two ships?
Well, because there weren't two ships at the same time, but there's been two ships of Theseus in space between the 7 years.
Ah, but not at the same time?
No.
One first, then another one?
Yeah.
Okay. When did this other Ship of Theseus arrive on the seas?
When all the pieces had to be changed.
So when all the pieces were changed?
Yeah.
When would that be exactly? So if the last piece changed in our story was the engine, is that the moment when there's a new ship arrives?
Yeah, because practically every part's been replaced.
Thank you. Pass on to someone who doesn't agree with you. Lovely. It's Ocean.
I say the red one is the spaceship of Theseus because that was made a spaceship of Theseus. Now if there's a second one, it'll have to be at the spaceships of Theseus.
So there's a difference between saying which is the spaceship on our question and which are the spaceships. Thank you. That's an observant thing to look at, the spaceship of Theseus. Okay. Let's have a handful more responses and we should end.
Well, if you can't decide which one's going in the museum, put them together. Like, if you take a wing off and put from the other spaceship a wing on, or take a window off and put another window on, then there would be both Theseuses, so there'd be, like, the one that arrived and ended. Like, if you can't decide over red and blue, put them together and it'll make purple. So that, if you swap all the parts, but they've still got, like, the shell of the coming down, the windows are going up, one wing coming down, one wing going up, then they're both the same as three seasons.
Two more people now.
I think they're both Theseus is because he drove them both, and like it don't matter if a part breaks, it still is, and like if somebody lost a leg in the army, it's still their leg, and it's like the same with a spaceship. And like if it's lost a wing, it's still Theseus, and he drove them both.
Thank you, Keith. It's the second time someone's made a comparison. Someone said there's a window in your house breaks, and someone said there's something in your body breaks. People are making comparisons to try and help us understand. What about people? And see other people have got something to say. What about people with another chance? Chloe, can you think of anything about which is the spaceship of Theseus? Do you have a feeling that it's one rather than the other?
I think it's the red one. Because if like that one's gone up, then it's like if that one's gone up, but it's not come back down the same, but it's still Theseus's rocket though.
Thank you. If it's gone up and it hasn't come back down the same, it's still Theseus's rocket. Okay. Let's end our session with a quick reflection. Shall we try and collect five interesting things that someone else has said? So, have a bit of a think. Who said something that was really helpful, that really made you think?
I liked Sophie's bit where she says you can just take, if you can't decide, you can just take pieces off because it could help the situation instead of people just thinking one answer and then another, they might think all the same after the idea has been shown.
Four more things.
I agree. I think Keith's idea was good because it if someone leaves an idea, like a spaceship loses their point of life.
Well done, Keith. Thank you, Maisie. Three more.
I like Sophie's idea about mixing the two together to make the same faces but different in some certain ways.
Thank you. Sophie's idea was that?
Yeah,
thank you. Well done, Sophie. Two more.
I like Sophie's idea when she says, so it's exactly the same, but one of the wings and one of the wing is.
Okay, well done again, Sophie. And finally.
I like Sophie though. She said, if you can't decide, then why don't you take two colours and mix them and make one, which is purple.
Okay. Even though I've just said one more person, let's have one more person because the last three people spoke about Sophie's. Was there anyone who said something interesting in addition to Sophie's? So could you pass to Trafford and we'll just hear one last one. Is this about Sophie, Trafford?
No.
Okay, good.
I think I can't remember who it was, but somebody, I think it was somebody on this side, but somebody says if it's the same crew but different spaceship, it's still his.
Okay. Cameron?
Yeah.
Well remembered, because if I remember correctly, Cameron said that very early on in the inquiry. In fact, if I look on my list, it's one of the first things that was said. Same crew. So well done. Some really, really careful listening, some really, really careful thinking. I think you had a really good session and you should give yourselves a clap.